Hi everyone. In this tutorial, we will create a React Swiper slider with GSAP animations, CSS mask effects, and autoplay functionality. This slider features smooth image transitions combined with a star-shaped mask effect. Let's get started. I created this project using Vite since Create React App is deprecated. There are no major differences in setting up the project. I've left a link in the description for those who don't know how to create a project with it. Before starting, I updated the source folder and added images to the public folder. In this project, the entry file is main instead of index.js. Let's move on to app. The app contains the slider component. We import it and render it inside the app. Now let's move on to creating the slider. First, we install Swiper and GSAP using the terminal. Next, we import the necessary libraries. Swiper provides the slider functionality and GSAP will handle the animations. We also import Swiper modules like fade effect, pagination, autoplay, and mouse wheel. By the way, I've added the Swiper documentation link in the description. Then we import the CSS and GSAP library. Here is the data array including the titles and images. The slider component contains the Swiper structure. We add modules to enable the fade effect, pagination, autoplay, and mouse wheel. The slider uses the fade effect to create smooth transitions. We enable pagination and mouse wheel controls. The autoplay feature changes slides every 4 seconds. The loop feature creates infinite scrolling. We use the map method to loop through the data array. The key prop is set to the current index to ensure each slide is unique. Each slide contains a title and 2 images. These image layers will be animated with GSAP. The second image layer uses the mask image property with an SVG shape. This creates the star mask effect. We create Swiper ref to store the Swiper instance and image refs to keep references to the image elements. We assign the Swiper instance to SwiperRef using the ref attribute. We store each image element in ImageRef's current using the ref attribute. The index ensures that images are stored in the correct order. The useEffect hook allows accessing the Swiper instance and triggering animations. It runs only once when the component mounts. This ensures that event listeners and animations work correctly. Then we access the Swiper object with this. It helps us control the slider and trigger animations. This function animates the images inside each slide. But before that, I disable autoplay so it doesn't cause distractions. We select the 2 images of the active slide by slicing the array. For the first slide, this slice method returns the images at index 0 and 1. For the second slide, this one returns the images at index 2 and 3. This pattern continues for the following slides, selecting 2 images at a time. If you'd like to learn more about the slice method, I'll leave the MDN document in the description below. GSAP animates the images inside each slide. When a slide becomes active, the images scale up staggered. The animation starts with the masked image and ends with the full image. The images return to their original size after the zoom-in effect. The slide change transition start event triggers the animation when the slide changes. We call the animateSlide function to apply the animation to the first slide when the page is loaded. Before each slide transition, we reset all animations. We use Kill Tweens Off to stop any ongoing GSAP animations. Then we reset the image scale to its default value. Now let's move on to the CSS. Here we'll create the mask effect, text animation, and add media queries for responsiveness. The font family is applied to the title. The slider is styled to cover the full screen. The layout is built using CSS Grid. The two image layers are stacked on top of each other. The second image layer uses the mask image property to create the star mask effect. I'll leave this SVG file in the description so you can download it if you want. A semi-transparent dark layer makes the mask effect more visible. The title is centered on the slide. It appears with a slide-in animation when the slide becomes active. The pagination bullets are small circles. The active bullet becomes larger with smooth transitions. The media queries adjust the mask size for different screen sizes. And there you have it. We've built a React Swiper slider with GSAP animation, CSS mask effect, and autoplay functionality. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the bell icon so you never miss out on the latest tutorials. Thanks for watching.